Hello, my name's Graham Moss. This video is an update on the changes in NCC 2022 for fire resistance in Section C. First change to show you is C2D10, non-combustible building elements. This is currently known as C1.9 in NCC 2019. It's been structured this way for a long time. You've got A and B, which set out things that have to be non-combustible: external walls, shafts, flooring of lift pits, and things like that. You've also got subclause C, which points to spec C1.1 for load-bearing internal walls and also load-bearing firewalls and the combustibility requirements found in that specification. You've also got D, which has a small number of concessions from the non-combustibility requirements of A and B. Now, currently in 2019, that list has seven things in it. There's gaskets, caulking, sealants, and a few other things. There's seven things in that list. And then you have C1.9E. Now, this is a concession list, but it's a concession of things that can be used despite being combustible. They can be used where things need to be non-combustible for purposes of A and B, but of course anywhere in the NCC. So C1.9D is a limited concession list, but C1.9E is a concession list for everything in the NCC, in the Building Code Volume 1, that needs to be non-combustible. First change I want to show you for 2022 is that what's currently C1.9E is pushed down to the new subclause, subclause 6, to make space for a new subclause 5. Now, this new subclause 5 is a list of materials that can be used wherever something needs to be non-combustible, because really they are non-combustible. So apparently test labs have been getting phone calls from manufacturers saying, can you do a combustibility test on our bricks? We're being asked for a certificate. Now, just for the record, the BCA has never required that you'd need to go to an accredited testing laboratory to do a combustibility test for a brick wall, or any wall for that matter. Now, of course, it might be chosen to use to get a combustibility test for reasons of evidence of suitability, and that's a good idea for something which is a wall system that is not known. However, the BCA has never actually required it. For some things, yes. So for instance, where a wall needs to achieve a fire resistance level, and it falls outside the specifications found inside the BCA, and it's therefore is a tested system, well, yes, the BCA is requiring that an accredited testing laboratory be used for those circumstances, but we've never actually asked for proof of non-combustibility for a brick wall. Now, regardless of this, we have inserted a new list of concessions in C2D10 subclause 5, and it's not just bricks. Bricks are there in C for masonry. But you can see this list of things which are non-combustible or non-combustible in nature. These are things that have been included in NCC 2022 as a general concession for reasons similar to that I've described for masonry. Now that's the new C2D10-5 for material concessions. Next, I want to talk about what's currently C19D, that list of things which can be combustible but don't have to comply with C19A and B. Now, you may recall there were seven things in that list: gaskets, caulking, sealants, termite protection, and other things. That list has grown now to 21 items. I say 21 because 6B there is a new system, external wall system, thermal breaks. Now, because thermal breaks for glazing systems are currently receive a concession, but basically from 6B onwards, these are all new concessions included in C2D10. The next change to show you is C2D14, ancillary elements. This provision has received some changes for NCC 2022. It's currently known as C114 in NCC 2019. Now, C114 is that provision that sets out things that can be attached to an external wall or be found within an external wall. And it's the reason why downpipes, for instance, for Type A and Type B buildings can be combustible. There are some minor changes for NCC 2022, including some additional concessions, but also some clarifications. One of those concessions is to do with these things: air conditioning condenser units outside, like this on Class 2s and 3s. Now, these need to connect to the split system inside through the external wall. And a lot of certifiers have been requiring performance solutions because the penetration sleeve, the penetration insulation, is combustible and found inside the external wall. So for 2022, C2D14 has a new concession that allows the insulation for the penetration sleeve to be combustible, but also to have other combustible items for service penetrations. As for clarifications, we've included a new note that points out that this is allowed. That is, an air conditioning condenser unit, despite having combustible parts, can be mounted on external walls of Type A and Type B buildings. Another clarification found in C2D14 is about something that we call in the office the kitchen cabinet issue. Here we have a high-rise apartment. It's type A construction. We're looking at the inside of some external walls here. We've got a kitchen placed against one of the external walls, and we've got some windows leading onto the balcony, which is the other external wall. Now, those kitchen cabinets attach to the inside of that external wall. Do those kitchen cabinets have to be non-combustible? But what if we put some internal blinds on those windows? Do those internal blinds have to be non-combustible? Well, under 2019, some people say they do because C114 talks about ancillary elements that are fixed to the internal parts of an external wall. Those kitchen cabinets are hanging off the internal frame of the external wall, and so people will be saying that yes, these things need to be non-combustible. In the same way that blinds, if they were attached to that external wall, would be attached to the internal parts of that external wall, to the framing, etc. Now, C114 has never intended to apply to things inside the building in this way. That's why we have C1.10, to cover the internal fire hazard properties. Things that are inside the wall itself, that's what we're interested in, and that's why the provision talks about the internal parts of an external wall. But we've never intended for this provision to apply for things inside the wall, inside the building, like the kitchen cabinets and the blinds. So we've changed C114 to include this limitation just to make it clear that this provision does not apply to things that are fixed on the inside of the external wall, like the kitchen cabinets, the internal blinds, anything like that. It was never meant to, and this addition for NCC 2022 makes that clear. Now, some may say that a kitchen cabinet attached to the internal parts, say the frame of the external wall, is still something that's subject to C114 or now C2D14. However, it's the opinion of the ABCB office that that kitchen cabinet that might be attached to blocking or framework inside the external wall is still a kitchen cabinet that is installed or attached to the internal face or to the lining of the external wall. It's still fixed to that lining despite being screwed into the blocking or the frame behind. Therefore, the limitation applies and kitchen cabinets are excluded from this provision. Next change is a new provision, C2D15, fixing of bonded laminated cladding panels. Now, we're not just talking about aluminium panels like honeycomb panels. This is a provision that applies to any cladding panel on a type A or type B building that is a panel that is bonded and laminated. Now, in a nutshell, what this provision is requiring that the fixing must be mechanical, for example, a cassette style fixing. Tape or glue fixing is not allowed on account of C2D15. Now, you can still use adhesives in addition to mechanical fixing, so you can tape it in place and then screw it in, but you can't use the tape or glue as the sole fixing. This is because mechanical fixing will do a better job of preventing the panel from coming away in a building fire. Now, note that this provision has some concessions in subclause 2. This new fixing provision doesn't apply to the cladding panels that are listed in subclause 2. Now, this is not a free kick. This concession list is not a way of saying, hey, you can go and use glue, or hey, you can just use some double-sided tape for these particular panels. In fact, it's very unlikely that if you tape fix these things, say fibre cement sheet, to an external wall, that it would meet the requirements of Section B. And that's why we've got this explanatory information box, which points out that there's other provisions of the NCC that apply to cladding panels, and it's very, very unlikely that you'll meet those particular requirements simply using tape or glue for fixing those items listed in subclause 2.